silence your cell phones. Flash photography will also pajamas, the best thing since sliced bread, it's Nick Cassano!
Hello everyone and welcome back to Pit Tonight! Now with 30% less sober. Let's get into some news here. Elon Musk recently debuted his own rebellious AI chatbot named Grok. Finally, Elon can have a rebellious child that isn't able to publicly disown her. The driver of a van with a missing tire attempted to evade the police while carrying 326 cases of beer. 326 cases of beer? Damn. I hope they find a cure soon. The Wiggles were, quote, deeply disappointed with a city council's decision to play a hot potato to drive out the homeless. I guess the council would prefer if the homeless lived in their big red cars instead. Twitch streamer Anna Grant revealed that a beer company wants to use her vaginal yeast to brew a new flavor. Unbeknownst to Anna Grant, I also brew a new flavor of beer using her vaginal yeast. A new First Nation policy limits Seattle police from knowing who I am. The law does not, however, remove the police's ability to cross their fingers behind their back or say it was just a prank, bro. Ohio, I know, has shockingly voted to legalize recreational marijuana. Now, it's great and also it's a good move for progress, but I'll stick it to fentanyl. Cassano's my name, and goofy fentanyl is my game. But you know what pairs well with my daily fent? A tall glass of farm fresh, pasteurized, delicious milk. We don't pay, but that's fun. You want some? Tanks and cattle semen were reported stolen from a town in the UK. They thought they had come, but in fact, they had gone. Renovations at Hilton Library have put a hole in the side of the building, leaving offices exposed to freezing cold temperatures. One librarian said they preferred the hole before they had kids with it, now it's just too loose and not satisfying. Man, these jokes are making me parched. Come on, man, let's go. I'm bulking, okay? Don't let me get this low next time. see you there. Well, you got me. I'm just here in my little book, preparing for my family to come for Thanksgiving. Not real Thanksgiving, oh God, no. Pre-Thanksgiving, with all the weird relatives I don't want to see during the actual Thanksgiving. But get it out of the way. First on that list is my brother, Eddie. He's had some bad luck in the women and prophecy departments, sometimes at the same time.
Ding dong!
It's gotta be there. Let's see.
How about that weather, huh?
I have to say,
is insane. Can't believe I'm a part of Nick's kooky family. I just wish there was some way I could find out that I'm not related to these people. Germany is trying to invade the United States by pulling a line to Mexico?
Sorry, wrong color.
Oh, I'm adopted! Oh, Mother's Day! Now get out! Yeah, giving you Eddie. How about that song, man? Anyway, this Thanksgiving, you know what I'm thankful for? DNA testing. And no, we'll be right back with more tonight.
Yeah, right. We've come a long way since then, and you know, suddenly we need to be able to.
had a couple games so far this season as well, right? I honestly need to follow them closely, but we're doing pretty good. A little bit different than maybe the start of your first.
Yeah. So again, 2 years ago today, we lost by 9 points to the Citadel at home. The Citadel Military College of South Carolina. If you haven't heard of them, that's why it was a bad loss.
Okay.
So now fast forward to this week, just kicked off the season, and our team just looks not even a difference. We've scored almost 200 points in the first two games. We have a freshman point guard, Bell Carrington, out of Baltimore, who dropped a triple double, so double figures in points, rebounds, and assists in his first game, second ACC player to ever do it in the debut. Just a really special team. Obviously, as I'm sure many of you guys know, we made it to a tournament, ending a six-year drought last season. And, this program is built with momentum, and quite honestly, the students are as well. So, we love seeing all the students come out to games, and just even from last year when we had a great roster together, we've more than doubled our attendance.
Wow.
For these really small. I mean, we played the Binghamton yesterday.
Sure.
I can't tell you the Binghamton is. I know it's in New
York. Yeah.
we had 1,400 students at the game yesterday.
Wow.
A year ago, we had 7.
Okay, so that's a good growth there. I mean, if the team's doing better, your students are doing, showing out more. What is that like for you as one of the leaders of this organization? How's it affecting the day-to-day? What does it look like boots on the ground for you guys?
Well, first thing, having a good team just makes the job so much easier. That's what my old leaders tell me, is that when a team's good, your job is so much easier. The job of creating a hostile environment is just, that much easier.
Yeah, trying to throw the guys out for you.
So the history of the Open Zoo is that you just have this raucous environment where Pitt, for a period of about 15 years, just ran college basketball as an elite basketball program, and the students, it was the toughest thing to get in Pittsburgh. You have the Steelers, Pirates, Bengals, and Pitt football, although they never had a problem with having tickets.
Sure. Maybe this year is not. Talk about the good team.
For 15 years, you couldn't get a ticket to a basketball game. Like, if you had the story I've been told, is if you had a ticket to see Steelers, Bengals, and Pirates game versus a ticket for the basketball, you take it to the basketball because you just wouldn't exist. That building was full of everything.
Yeah.
You play teams like Duke and UConn, and you win those huge games. We're still on the lead against the top five.
Okay.
We love that they have awesome resources that allows us.
Sure.
Not at Wall Street. So having been at Wall Street actually active this semester has been constant because they can say they should have.
You ever have like informants, you know, slipping them a little tips on you?
I've said it so.
Okay. These are covert operations. That's nice. like certain fake money floating around. You guys can sanction that, obviously. But the ability to swing whenever it's supposed to be like in a team, huge perk. If I'm a student who's not a big basketball fan, I'm not involved with the zoo at all. What's your pitch?
I'm tired of the jig. You'll get the jig to get all the way. You know.
is bold, better be creative. That's all I'm saying. Let's do the next round. I'm really not so sure about that one.
That's
more common than studio session. Okay, fantastic. Maybe that's on you. The guys in the free throw line are trying to come on this game or something like that.
I mean, anything goes.
Okay, so then I guess, I don't know if the student, can we call them animal? I'm not sure if it fit the criteria here.
So in
this
case,
the
video continues.
Okay.
It's possible. It's so great. Like, you'll see him sitting in the middle of it, and you're just like, wow, you're just giving it, like, to the big
total to the face.
I know.
Alright, so we have all the guests here. Okay, show me those loot. Oh, dude, classic American bison. Come on, man. That's you guys are great. I think we got a couple more here, so let's hear this.
I don't fucking know what a turtle sounds like.
Okay. Thank you. For this evening, fresh off the heels of their debut single, My Friend, please make some noise for Oakland's own 957.
Hi guys. Okay, we're gonna play three little songs for you. This first one is called Take Me. Just give us a second. Okay, you know what? I'm forgetting the pedals, and I'm just gonna play it straight to the end because they're acting like a little bit just today.
Thank you.
beach house, so I'm really sorry. But Space Alarm by 957, which is a little bit less cool. But yeah, I don't have my pedals, so it might sound a little bit booty cheeks, but yeah, let's get going with it.
Thank you.
only single out. By the way, I'm Yanni. I am the guitarist and the singer and also the bassist for this band. And this is our lovely friend, Ryan. She's also the guitarist, singer, and bassist for the band. And then Aaron, our drummer, and Owen on guitar. We just have one single out on Spotify, and it's called My Friend, and that is what we're gonna play for you guys right now. So I hope you guys enjoy.
He said.